Yeah, sound the alarm, Spot. We've got an issue.
I don't know what's going on. I just got up this morning and I went to go check on my reptile room. I called Mategu L to check up on her and she's doing just fine and her ears are right where I left them. I checked on my gecko next. She's doing fine. Her ears are there. But when I called my boa Cleo, nothing. She didn't come.
Look, Cleo. Cleo. Here, Cleo. Cleo, can you hear me?
Nothing. It's been like that all morning.
And that's when it hit me. My snakes never had ears.
Oh yeah, that's right.
But why is that?
That means that a rattlesnake has never heard the sound of its own rattle, a gaboon viper has never heard the amazing hiss that comes from gaboon vipers or puff adders, and king cobras have probably never heard how terrifying their own growl sounds.
I know, it's a tragedy.
And most importantly, does my rattlesnake even know his name is Sir Squigglepants?
Alright, so I'm just kidding. His name's Spot. But if he can't hear me, it might as well be something as ridiculous as Sir Squigglepants. So why don't they have ears?
So part of the reason the snakes don't have ears comes from the fact that they are not social animals. They're pretty solitary and they don't have a need to communicate with members of their own species. Which means there's not that much of a need for them to hear the sounds that they make because other members of their species aren't going to hear them either. And it just won't be used for communication. There's a myth out there that rattlesnakes can track down their hibernacula where they go to hibernate by listening for the sound of other rattlesnakes, and that just isn't true because they're not that social and they can't hear the sound of their own rattle. And we know this because scientists wanted to test if rattlesnakes were using the sound of other rattlesnakes to find a place to hibernate, and when they play rattlesnake sounds for rattlesnakes, rattlesnakes don't react in any measurable way. So this already makes a little more sense for why snakes don't have ears. They're not like birds or people or canines or other animals that have ways of socially communicating with each other. They don't have that need, so there's no need for them to be able to hear each other. Okay, but even if snakes aren't social creatures and have a diminished need for hearing because they don't need to hear what they're saying to each other, doesn't it make sense that most animals still have big ears and great hearing ability to be able to avoid predators? Well, yeah, threat detection is a big reason why so many animals have such heightened sense of hearing, because if you can hear a threat coming, then you can prepare for it and flee and be long gone by the time that threat actually gets to where you are. So it would be a huge handicap if snakes or any animal couldn't hear what was approaching them and couldn't gauge threats by just hearing them and preparing. Which is why even though snakes look like they don't have ears and they are lacking the external ears that we have, they do hear and they do have a type of ears, in a sense. Get it? In a sense? Like, sense of hearing? I'm sorry, I can already hear you groaning at that pun. And that's because my outer ear acts like a funnel that collects sound waves traveling towards it that then travel through the auditory canal to my middle ear, which consists of three bones, the malleus, the stapes, and incus, that work as a way of physically amplifying the sound collected by the outer ear before it travels to the inner ear, where the cochlea picks up the sound vibrations with little hairs called stereocilia that convert the sound waves to electrical signals that then finally travel up the auditory nerve to my brain, which then tells me to make more bad jokes because your groans only fuel me. But the wild thing is, even though snakes are lacking the external ears that we associate with collecting sound and processing hearing, they actually pretty much do all the other steps of the hearing process that I just laid out. And Lucy here might have even heard you guys groan, and that's because of the specific wavelengths of sound that snakes are able to hear, and I'll get a little bit more into that later when I talk about if your snake can actually hear your voice. But how is all this possible? Because as the video started off with, snakes don't have ears. Or do they? While snakes are missing the outer ear us and many other animals rely on to hear, they still have the inner ear component and a modified middle ear as well. Or do they? Yes, they do.
Well, kind of. They have the cochlea in their inner ear that converts sound vibrations into electrical signals, and those vibrations get amplified by the snake's version of the middle ear that similarly to ours are made of bone, but instead of a malleus, stapes, and incus, snakes have just two amplifying bones called the quadrate and columella that attach directly to the snake's jaw bones.
So snakes do have ears, they're just in their jaw bones?
Well, kind of. Where we have kind of funnel-like outer ears designed to collect airborne sound waves, snakes use their jawbone, that's usually resting on whatever surface they are resting on, to pick up vibrations that are traveling through the ground. Those sound waves then travel through the snake's jaw, go to their version of the middle ear that consists of the quadrate and columella, and then those two bones, like our middle ear, amplify the sound, then transfers those amplified vibrations to the snake's inner ear. The cochlea then receives these vibrations and converts them to nerve impulses their brains can understand.
So snakes do have ears, they're just ears that have been optimized for a solitary life spent living on the ground. This does give snakes a much more narrow range of hearing. For most species, it's somewhere between 80 and 600 hertz. And for comparison, humans can hear frequencies from as low as around 20 hertz all the way on up to about 20,000 hertz. So if you're comparing snake hearing to human hearing, you can kind of think about it similarly to how us as humans only hear a fraction of all the sounds that dogs hear or elephants hear or something like that. Similarly, snakes can only hear a small fraction of everything that we can hear. But all that being said, we now know snakes do have at least some version of ears. And that finally begs the question, does your snake know its name? Well, probably not. But not because they can't hear you. The average human voice travels at around 250 hertz, putting it smack dab in the middle of that 80 to 600 hertz range that most snakes are able to hear. But because they're not really social animals, it's very unlikely that they have any comprehension of what you were saying or that you were using their name or anything like that. So feel free to name your snake, nickname your snake, rename your snake, whatever you would like, because chances are they're not gonna mind whatever you call them. And at the end of the day, snakes are kinda like cats. Even if they could hear you calling their name, they're not coming. Anyway, that does it for this video. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. And if you did, you should know that this week's video topic was chosen by my patrons over on Patreon. I just started a Patreon where you can sign up to support the channel for as little as $3 a month. And other tiers get exclusive voting rights to choose the topic of one video a month. So if you enjoy what I do and want to help keep the channel going and get to help pick what videos I make, so check out the Patreon link in my description if you are interested in having that sort of creative control over the channel and want to help pick what October's patron chosen video will end up being. And with that, I would like to thank all of the current patrons that made this video possible. Starting with the patrons in the Head Herpers tier, I owe a special thank you to Amanda Lynn, Bobby Cromer, Lindsay Justice, and Lavenders for supporting this page at the highest level every month. And I appreciate all the other names scrolling by right now just as much, because this channel would not be possible without you guys. So thank you so, so much for your support. Anyway, I think that does it for real. So if you're still here, make sure you hit the like button if you haven't. Thank you so much for watching this week's video. I hope you have a fantastic rest of your week. I hope all of your animals that are supposed to have ears where you left them. But most of all, I hope that you just keep herpin'.